Most cases will ship with at least a few fans, which should give you adequate cooling for a typical system. For those of you who are not satisfied with adequate cooling, keep listening and we will discuss aftermarket case fans and how to determine what is best for your rig. Let's first discuss some of the main specifications and factors to consider when choosing aftermarket case fans for your rig. A regular 3-pin fan has wires for power, ground, and tack. Tack relays information to your motherboard or software like RPM. The 4th pin found on some case fans allows for PWM or pulse width modulation, which allows for your motherboard or fan control software to adjust the speed of your fan. Revolutions per minute or RPM tells us how many times the fan will make a complete rotation in 1 minute. The higher the RPM, the faster the fan is spinning. And in most cases, the louder the fan is going to be. 120mm case fans tend to be the most popular size of fans in modern PC cases, but you will find many sizes such as 80mm, 92mm, 140mm, 200mm and beyond. Fan size is closely related to airflow in that larger fans will push more air than smaller ones while running at the same RPM. What this means is that larger fans can spin much slowly than smaller ones while still pushing the same amount of air, which is great for lowering noise levels. Another way to compare fans is to look at their noise level, which is usually measured in dBA or decibel. The most obvious way to compare the noise level of different fans is to look at their specs on the box. However, this can be deceiving since different manufacturers may test fan noise in a variety of different ways. For example, one does not usually know how far away from the fan the dBA meter is sitting and what the background noise in the tester room is like. Cubic feet per minute tells us how much air the fan is capable of moving. For a typical case fan, this is the most telling spec when it comes to the fan's cooling performance. Static pressure is measured in units of mmH2O. The higher the number is, the more force the fan can exert on an object. Static pressure is most important when you are mounting your fan to something that will block some of its airflow, such as a water cooling radiator, CPU heatsink, or on hard drive cage, where the fan will be obstructed by the hard drives. Measured in amps, this tells you how much power the fan will use. To convert this figure to maximum wattage, you will want to multiply it by the maximum voltage the fan supports. In addition to making your system perform better, adding aftermarket fans can also be a way to further customize the look of your system. Aftermarket fans may come with interchangeable colored rings so that you can color coordinate with your system's motherboard, graphics card, or memory. Colored LED fans are also available for anyone who wants to light the system up. Both types are optimized for different types of use. Airflow fans is best to use when you want to move air efficiently and have little to nothing blocking the fan. Static pressure fans are the better options if you need to push air through an object, such as a water cooling radiator, CPU heatsink, hard drive cage, or any type of obstruction.